Next, I would like to call upon Mr. Hemant Shilwan. He is the head of Innovation and DNA Startup Alliance at Robert Bosch Engineering and Business Solutions. And Hemant's specific interests are in the areas of AI-based personalization engine, specifically for retail and mobility. So Hemant, over to you, and we would like to hear about what is it that you do at Robert Bosch. Thank you.
Good morning, one and all. I'm Hemant. Thanks, Shyam. Thanks, Jules, for allowing me to be a part of this session. Quite excited. So I'm Hemant. I am with Robert Bosch, working in this since the past 17, 18 years, but also taking care of multiple topics, right? So Bosch is one place where being in a single company, you can get a feel of multiple things. So today, the topic itself, deep tech for good, has been quite interesting. So when Jose actually told to me about this topic, several things actually came to my mind, right? So what is deep tech? Yeah. So while we are talking about deep tech for good, at Bosch, what motivates us is being a part of Invented for Life. Bosch has a tagline of Invented for Life. And we want our products to spark enthusiasm. We want to improve the quality of life and also help conserve natural resources. So the topic deep tech for good is quite interesting that way. Yeah. So today we have multiple definitions of deep tech, right? So deep tech is a set of cutting edge and disruptive technologies. So this is from startupbusiness.it. Then where it is actually based on scientific discoveries, engineering, mathematics, fundamental science, which is quite important. So what category falls under deep tech? So we have artificial intelligence, we have the drones and robotics, we have blockchain, we have AR, VR, we have advanced materials, quantum computing, all falling into the purview of deep tech. So this is a slide from NASSCOM, Zinnow, where we see that even in India, 18% of all startups are now actually leveraging deep tech. So if you see, artificial intelligence is at the top, but IoT, big data analytics, blockchain, AR, VR are actually not very far behind. So it varies across a multiple set of industries, whether it be fintech, retail, healthcare, so all these things. So at Bosch, Robert Bosch Engineering and Business Solutions is a company where it is just after Germany. It is one of the largest R&D centers for Bosch, based out of Bangalore and Coimbatore in India, but also has offices across the globe. So we have now development centers in Vietnam, Mexico, Poland. But with respect to the deep tech, what do we focus on? Is basically these things. So blockchain, agriculture, retail, electric vehicles, mobility solutions, healthcare domain, energy domain. So Bosch being having 21,000 people, R&D engineers, working for it in India, from India, actually caters to all these segments as well. So while we talked about deep tech, I would want to take these through set of case studies, right? So the first thing on a deep tech, what I will take you through is what is called a digital twin. So what is a digital twin? What is a digital twin? So when you look at how machines, large components, where you have very less access to the machines itself, where you would want to monitor all the machines throughout. So if you have such machines, it's very tough to really monitor it at a very regular interval, right? So digital twin, what it does is it replicates a physical component into a digital persona, and also gives an advantage by helping to reach out digitally the health of the machine, to monitor and know the health of the machine, to enable predictive diagnostics, thus enabling a business at any level to really ensure that their operations are running hassle-free. Yeah. So what customer problems are we solving? We are talking about how customers are struggling to manage assets. We're talking about how efficiency, there's a lack of transparency towards efficiency. So digital twin actually helps to overcome all these things. So another one which I would like to go through is called Phantom. Phantom is a scalable IoT solution from Bosch, which works with smart meters, but in a different way. So what's the difference? It is non-intrusive. It's a non-intrusive load monitoring energy device, which can be easily plugged into any of the electrical the hubs to a real-time monitor the status of the electrical devices through their signatures. So this is a very good depiction of what a smart meter is doing. We are not just looking at insights that goes into consumption, right? I mean, saving a consumption, 100 rupees, 200 rupees in India is not too much. But then if you can identify that the equipment has started failing now, yeah, and I'm able to alert you maybe 6 months before itself, you're able to save a lot of electricity there. You're able to save a lot of downtime. You're able to save a lot of non-productive hours through Phantom. Going on to the next dimension where we are talking about customer experience. While Phantom and Digital Twin talked about operations, here we're talking about customer experience. So Eero is one such outcome which started as an entrepreneurial venture. In fact, I was one of the persons starting it, which built an AI platform to understand the preferences of the customer, to understand that build a 360-degree consumer profile, and from there enable the businesses to really target the consumer in the right way, using a recommendation engine which was based on AI and machine learning, delivering personalized experience through a hyper-personalized targeting to the customer, while also taking care of the GDPR norms. Yeah, I mean, we don't want to invade too much into the privacy, but only to that person, understanding the person, the phone acts more like a personal assistant. Yeah, this showcases in a mobility, in an automotive, how a personalization works, AI-based personalization works. So you have, as soon as you enter the car, it welcomes you, it retrieves the profile, whether it is for the seat, the AC temperature, whether it is for the rearview mirrors, and it also helps to set the direction, in the maps, the navigation, based on your preferences, based on your habits. So this is AI playing a major role, personalizing the context for a consumer. The next one, what I will talk about is a blockchain, where we are talking about how AI, IoT, and DLT, DLT is the distributed ledger technology, actually come together to really enable tracking of, for example, TrueFood is a component which actually tracks from farm to fork how the food is going, where it was grown, how it was stored, while storing, what was the temperature. So we are able to, at any point in time, tag and store the information for all these things. So this is an example from consumer through retailer, through fruit manufacturer, farmer and supply chain, how you are able to use blockchain and AI to really look at how to deliver the best experience possible and how to ensure that whatever is being done is, whatever promised is actually got. So apart from this, as Bosch, we also have what we call DNA Next, which is a startup alliance program. So in fact, I take care of the startup alliance program, where we work with multiple startups, working with our business units, closely working, solving a problem statement to ensure that there is sustainability and that we ensure we go together in the ecosystem to solve a customer problem in an agile manner. So this is about the Bosch Group. Yeah. So our values are basically oriented towards sustainability, towards ensuring that people are given the right technology to ensure that our tagline "Invented for Life" actually holds good. Yeah. This is mine. Thank you.
Has wide application You talked about the digital twin, the phantom. A lot of it has to do with improving the operational efficiencies in industries. And of specific interest to me was the blockchain topic that you talked about, which has an impact on agriculture and the food chain. So thank you very much for that, Hemant.
Thanks.
It was very insightful.
Thanks.